So in this session we are going to talk about Apache NiFi clustering. So whenever you talk about installing NiFi in a production system, you always are going to consider installing NiFi in a cluster mode. It has its advantages, and today we are going to discuss all of those things. And also we will try to understand what is the basic difference in having a cluster system and having a non-cluster system. So if you are a beginner, you might be wondering what is a cluster. So cluster basically is a group of computers or group of servers, or you may call it a group of systems, which are joined together to form a single computer or single server or single system. So typically when you have some critical applications running, you always want to install that in a cluster, okay, because there are many limitations of having a non-cluster system. So before we want to understand cluster in detail, let's understand why we need a cluster system. Okay, so this is the main question that comes into everyone's mind when we start designing the architect of the application. So the first and foremost thing is you do not want a single point of failure. But that is the reason you would like to go ahead with a cluster system. If you have your application running only on one server, and in case that server goes down, or let's say operating system crashes, or for whatever reason you do not have access to that server, or let's say network goes down and you are now disconnected with that server, in that cases you will not be able to perform any action, or you will not be able to run the application which is deployed on that cluster. Okay, so basically you have a single point of failure. And whenever you are designing a production system, you always want to consider that you do not have a single point of failure. The other point to consider is that one server is not big enough to perform all the processing which you need. For example, let's consider you have a server with, let's say, 16 GB of RAM. And let's say the computing which you want to perform requires more than this much GB of RAM to perform the amount of work you want single server to handle. Okay, so in that case, if you are performing the work using one server, then the processing is going to be slow. And in some cases, you may not be able to perform the processing. So in that case, having the distributed system and letting each server work is basically going to give you the power to perform more processes, okay, and do more amount of work. Now the third point is, or the fourth point which is shown in this article here, is basically when as an administrator you are managing the system, then managing a single server or set of single servers are very difficult and complex than managing a cluster. One example is whenever you make any change in a code, you have to manually deploy that code on each server. Or if you're having a single server, you just have to make sure that code is deployed on that server. And let's say if you are running a server or set of three servers, but those are not part of cluster, you are just installing an application or NiFi in this case individually. In that case, you need to make sure that whenever you change any piece of code, you need to change on each servers manually. And that is a big headache, and also it is going to cause a lot of problems, and also it may result in more errors. So we don't want to end up into any of these situations which are mentioned here. We do want a robust system, and we want a system which is, you know, not having a single point of failure, where administration is easy and which can perform more processing. So now, just to prove this point of administering multiple system, let's consider this NiFi which is running on a standalone server. So this is running on my local host and this is running on port 9090. Okay, so this is a single server. This is how NiFi looks like when you have NiFi installed and running in a non-cluster mode. Now on the other tab, I have cluster NiFi open, and we will see what is the difference or how it looks like when you have a cluster NiFi running. Okay, so straight away you can see here you are seeing this icon which is saying connected nodes, and also it is showing total number of nodes in the cluster. So the first number or first three is basically suggesting that right now we have three number of nodes connected to this cluster, and the number on the right side is suggesting this is the total number of nodes which are available in the cluster. Okay, so sometime if one of the node goes down, then you are going to see here number 2. Okay, so basically you have 2 out of 3 nodes connected. In this case we have 3 out of 3 nodes connected. Now if you go back to single instance, you do not see that cluster icon. Okay, so that's how you can, just by looking at the user interface, you can differentiate between a cluster and a non-cluster system. Now on a non-cluster system, if I go to global menu and if I explore the options, I do not see any option related to cluster. Now let's go back to our cluster system, and here if I go back to global menu, you will see we have an extra icon which is called cluster. So if I select cluster here, I'll be able to see all the servers which are part of this cluster. Okay, so you can see I have node 1, I have node 3, I have node 2. If you want to sort it based on the name, you can just click here on the name address and this will get sorted. So now you can see node 1, node 2, node 3. And when we said managing a cluster system from a single user interface is easy, so what we meant was, so here you can see I have option of going to system, so I can see on each of the nodes how many total cores are available, what are the total number of threads are running, and so on. Okay, I can go to JVM and I can see the JVM related information for each of the server. Similarly, I can do the same for flow file, content storage, provenance storage, and versions. So let's say if I had 10 nodes as part of this cluster, in that case it had been very easy for me to just manage everything from a single user interface. Okay, so with this, let's also start discussing about some of the benefits of NiFi cluster. So first and foremost thing is that it is going to increase the system resources. Okay, so with that, what I mean is, let's say you have a set of file, let's say you have 3 files and each file is probably, let's say, 200 GB in size, and you want to process these files and load it to target, let's say you want to load it to Hadoop. So if you have single instance of NiFi running, then it is going to take more time for a single NiFi instance to, you know, read this file, perform the enrichment, and then load the data to Hadoop. However, when you have this running in a cluster system, then all the 3 nodes are going to work on one of the files. Okay, so node 1 may be working on one file, node 2 may be working on second file, and node 3 may be working on third file. So what this is going to do is, this is going to basically increase the speed of, you know, work done in a short amount of time. So in a technical term, this is going to increase the response time and throughput. Now the second option basically here is talking about that you have the option of scaling. So when you install NiFi in a cluster mode, and let's say later on you want to extend the system resources, then you can add another server and make that part of cluster as well. So if you have a NiFi cluster running, when you want to add a new node, you can just make that configuration in the new node and you can make that new node join the cluster. And the configurations are easy. We are going to discuss configuration also in next session, or probably in our subsequent sessions, if not in the next session. Now the third point here is, which we were discussing, that In NiFi clustering, we have single user interface to manage our data flows. So with that, what I mean is, let's say if I create a data flow here, so let's say I'm going to add a new processor, which is going to be get file. Then once I add this processor here, this is going to be automatically going to get copied to all the nodes. I do not have to do this thing manually. Okay, so it is NiFi cluster responsibility to make sure that the same code is available on all the nodes and it is uniform. So let's say I select get file, I select on add, and now I'm going to go to node 2, which is opened here. So once it opens, we should be able to see get file available here as well. Let me zoom out. Let me refresh third as well. So then we will refresh all of them and we will see that. And let me also go back to this node 1 and change it to rename this processor to, let's say, demo processor. By the way, right now you see empty canvas, but I have a lot of other processor running here. So if I go to navigate, you can see I have a lot of other stuff running as well. Okay, so now we should be, if we refresh here, we should be able to see demo processor here as well. Alright, yeah, demo processor is available here. Okay, you see demo processor is available here, and the same thing now I'm going to check here as well. Okay, so here also you see we have demo processor. Now let's say if I want to change the name of this processor, then what do I need to do? So in this case, basically you can log into any of the user interface of your cluster. So as you see in the cluster, we have three nodes. So I'm going to one of the cluster and going to open the cluster from global menu. You can see here we have three nodes. So if I want to create any data flow, I can log into any of the nodes, and any of the node is basically going to give us the same view. So you saw from here, node 1, we created a processor which is called demo processor. Now let's say for now I finished the work and later on I want to start again, then I may log into another user interface, which is node 2 or maybe node 3. And if I make any changes here, the same is going to get reflected on all the nodes. So I'm going to change it to demo processor updated. And I'm going to select apply, and it takes, you know, some time before your changes gets applied. So now you see we are on node 1, we already see demo processor name is updated, and here also on node 2, once it refreshes, you will see demo processor name getting updated. You saw now the name has been updated, and you are checking this from node 2 user interface. So regardless of which user interface you connect to, the operations are performed centrally and it is ensured that everything is in sync. So from a data flow manager perspective, their work is going to be very easy in terms of they just have to think about creating data flows. They don't have to worry about ensuring that all the codes are copied across all the nodes. The fourth thing which we already touched upon, that is monitoring everything from a single interface. Okay, this is going to make troubleshooting a lot easier. So let's say I'm here on node 1, and if I want to see how all the nodes are performing, I can just go to cluster from global menu and I can see the system resources and consumption. I can see JVM status. I can see where the heap utilization is increasing. So right now you can see heap utilization on node 1 is increasing, whereas all the other nodes are okay. You can see the status of garbage collector and stuff like that. Also, you can see flow file storage. You can see how much is the storage and how much is the available versus, you know, utilized storage on each of the nodes. You can see the storage of content and repository. You can see about provenance storage, and also you can see what are the versions of softwares which are running on each of these nodes. So from a monitoring point of view, it gives you so much flexibility and it makes it so much easier for you to manage everything just from a single window. I don't have to go to each of these servers to manage everything. Okay, I have put all the screenshots which we discussed. I have put those screenshots here. So if you want to refer that later, you can refer that from this website, from my article. Now let's discuss about some of the key terminology of NiFi cluster. So whenever we discuss about NiFi cluster, we talk about nodes. So what are nodes? Nodes are basically a single server which is actually performing the data processing. So in this case, nodes are basically, this server is a node. Okay, similarly, this is one of the server which is node. And this is again one of the servers which we are calling node. So node is basically any server or a single server which is a part of the cluster and which is going to perform the actual data processing. So after that, we have something which is called cluster coordinator. So as you saw when I was making changes in here in one of the processors, and when I changed the name, automatically it got updated on the other side as well. Okay, so all this task is taken care by cluster coordinator. And also if one of the node goes down and you want to, you know, perform the action of rejoining, so all of these kind of tasks are basically taken care by cluster coordinator. So if you go back to your NiFi global menu and go to cluster, just look at here in the status column. So here you can see one of the nodes are always going to be shown as coordinator. Okay, so right now node 3 is a coordinator node and all the other nodes are going to send heartbeat status to coordinator node, and coordinator is going to ensure that all the nodes are up and running. And if one of the nodes is not sending heartbeat status, in that case, coordinator is going to take some action of disconnecting that node and stuff like that. So basically, whatever is required from management point of view, that is going to be taken care by coordinator. And also notice, in case this server goes down, which is the currently acting as coordinator, in that case, this coordinator role is automatically going to be taken care by some other available nodes. Okay, so now we know about cluster coordinator. So cluster coordinator basically, it provides a single management point for the cluster. And also it periodically takes care of all the status of all the nodes. So all the nodes periodically sends heartbeats to cluster, and that is the way cluster ensures that all the nodes are up and running. Okay, so heartbeats are typically sent every 5 seconds. And if you want to change the second number of seconds, you can change it in the properties file, nifi.properties file. Okay, so this is configurable. And if any of the node is not sending heartbeat status for 40 seconds, in that case, that node is basically going to get disconnected from the cluster. And that action is going to be taken care by cluster coordinator. And once that node comes up again and it starts sending heartbeats, then cluster coordinator again going to request that node to join the cluster. So that's how management of joining and disconnecting the cluster happens. The other terminology is isolated processor. So what is an isolated processor? Now let's say for some reason when you are developing a flow and you don't want this processor to be running or executing on all the nodes, okay, you want it to be executing only on one node, and that node is going to be your primary node. Okay, so with primary node, what I mean is if you go again to the global menu and go to cluster, you will see along with coordinator we also have something called status of primary. So primary, out of your cluster, one node is going to be a primary node. Okay, and if one of the processor you want to run on only one node, then that node is going to be your primary node. And typically you perform this kind of actions in get file or get SFTP kind of processor. So let's say I have a get file processor. Using this I want to copy a file. Okay, so if the same processor is running and going to pick the same file from all the nodes, then we are going to get some errors. Okay, typically it happens in case of get SFTP, because let's say when you configure get SFTP, get SFTP is going to run, and here let's say if you have configured it to go on some server, let's say 10.0.0.1. So in this case, when this processor is running, okay, now you see on node 2 and node 3 also we have same copied, same getting distributed. Now when this processor is running, basically it is going to run on all the three servers, and all the three servers will try to connect to this server and bring the file, okay, which is going to result in some errors, because once get SFTP is going to copy a file, it is going to delete that file from the source, and in that case all the other nodes, one node is basically going to get successful and all the other nodes are going to get error that file is not found. Okay, in that case typically you want get SFTP kind of processor to be running only on one node. So to make that configuration, you right click on that processor and you go to configure, and then you go to scheduling, and here you have execution. In the execution, rather than all nodes, you select primary node. Also notice when I select primary node and I hit apply, you see there is a small P icon is displayed here. So what it means is that this processor is going to be running only on the primary node. However, it doesn't mean that the copy of this is not going to be shown when you log in from any other node. So this is node 1. However, if I log in from node 2 also, I'm still going to see get SFTP. So currently it is not updated. I think it updates, it refreshes every 30 seconds. So once it refreshes, we should be able to, yeah, now we can see we have this P icon here. Okay, so yeah, copy is going to be seen from everywhere, but when the actual execution happens, this processor is going to run only on the primary node. And that primary node can be dynamic, so based on the whatever is the current primary node. So for example, right now primary node is node 3, so this processor is going to run only on node 3 server, okay, or node 3 machine or node 3 system, whatever you want to call it. So that is what an isolated processor is. So isolated processor doesn't run on all the node of the cluster, it runs only on one of the nodes in the cluster. Primary node we already discussed, and you can follow this screenshot to understand more about primary nodes. Now let's talk about, or let's see an image of NiFi cluster, how a NiFi cluster looks like. So right now it is shown an image of 5 node cluster, which I have taken this screenshot from Apache NiFi website. So we had set up a 3 node cluster and this is a 5 node cluster. Now why we are setting odd number of nodes when we are setting up cluster? Okay, so that is because NiFi uses Zookeeper to set up the cluster. And if you read more about Zookeeper, you will understand that there is something called Zookeeper and Quorum. So basically Zookeeper has something called election process. Using that, it elects one of the nodes as a cluster coordinator. So for those sort of reason, it is always advisable that you select odd number of nodes. So if you want to set up NiFi cluster, you can go either with 3 nodes, you can go with 5 nodes or 7 nodes or so on. And if we talk about key features of NiFi cluster, then first thing which you need to understand is NiFi employs a zero master clustering paradigm. So what it means is that each of the node is going to work on a single file and going to perform the same task. Okay, so when I, let's say if I use split processor, okay, let's say when I'm using split text processor to split the text, so this split text processor is going to be running on all the 3 nodes. However, it is going to split the text of the file which is received on this node, okay, which is basically which is received to this node from any other previous, let's say, processor. So with that, what I mean is that single file is not going to be broken into multiple files and going to be handled by NiFi cluster. This NiFi clustering works a bit different when you compare it with, you know, Spark or probably Hadoop, Yarn or stuff like that. So in NiFi clustering, each of the node is going to perform the same task, and it is going to perform that task on, and it is going to perform that task on the file which it has received. Okay. And about Zookeeper election and coordination, you can read more about Zookeeper from Apache Zookeeper documentation. That will give you more understanding. But from NiFi perspective, we don't really need to understand Zookeeper in much detail. The only thing which you need to know about is that whenever you run Apache NiFi, there is an embedded Zookeeper which runs. And when we are going to set up cluster, we need to make sure that we have correct Zookeeper settings done. And after that, there is nothing much which we need to talk about in terms of Zookeeper. However, for your own understanding, it is always advisable that you go to Apache Zookeeper website and try to understand Zookeeper in more detail. So just a quick recap. In this section, we saw what is a cluster and why do we need a cluster. We also discussed about some of the benefits of having a NiFi cluster. Along the way, I also shown you what a single node or single NiFi or standalone NiFi looks like, and what is the difference between a cluster machine and how to identify a node or NiFi cluster. So again, here you see it is showing the cluster, and here again in the global menu you can see cluster option when you have NiFi running in a cluster. So that's it in this session. In subsequent sessions, we are going to discuss in more detail about how to set up this cluster. And also we are going to cover 2 scenarios. So in scenario 1, which is going to be like a development scenario, in that scenario, I'll be assuming that you have only one server or let's say one system where you want to set up NiFi cluster. So this is going to be useful if you want to practice installing NiFi cluster. And you can do that on your own laptop or your own desktop. And I will tell you what is the settings you need to do for that. And all of these things we will do in very detailed, and we will do step by step. So we will start from right from downloading the software, and then we will configure each of the things step by step. We are not going to hurry up in any of the sessions. Okay, so that's about approach 1. The approach 2, I'm going to show you individual 3 servers, and we'll be configuring NiFi cluster on those 3 servers. Okay, and we will see how cluster is configured, what are the settings you need to do. So this kind of configuration you'll be providing in a production environment.